So if you don't train yourself to remember death, remember the eternal, remember that there's something bigger going on, you'll stay caught in what you've been taught. That the definition, the measure of you is how much money do you make, how much are you held in esteem, how much power or prestige do you have, are you seen as somebody, do you sound intelligent, what do people think of you? You have a position in the world. Are you rich? Are you famous? Are you contributing? Are you doing something important? All of which instantly disappears the moment you actually die, that all of you dies. When your heart stops beating, all of you is dead. But at some point, all of you is dead. And you're completely done with this lifetime. And either this lifetime added to your essence, to your being, call it your soul, whatever you want, but it's being, the consciousness that continues. Have you added to it and made it better? Have you made it bigger-hearted and wiser? Or have you and able to see more clear and understand more deeply? Or have you frittered away your time with what they trained you to do, like a trained monkey, to make money, go up the corporate ladder, or write really good poems? You know, it can be noble work, but it's still of this world. It's still gone the moment you're truly gone. It still will be possible to evaluate it, that either it added to your soul or it didn't. If it didn't, it's trivial and not worth more time and attention than it's actually worth. And if it's not trivial, it's profound, it's eternal, it has something to do with the ultimate and the supreme and the divine. And the majority of your time and attention and blood and sweat and tears and everything else is rightly invested in that. And poorly invested when that same investment went into the world, where it just gets swallowed up. And then when you leave, it stays. And you get nothing. But what you build inside you goes with you. So if you make yourself more loving, what goes with you is a greater lovingness. And if you make yourself very rich with money, what goes with you is a poverty of lovingness. Because you used your time and energy for money instead of love, which is the capacity for love. So you have to really, really understand the measure of life. The measure of life is, how are you investing? Are you investing in the worldly life, or are you investing in the life that continues? Are you investing in the permanent life or the temporary life? Are you investing wisely or ignorantly? And your investment is your destiny. So if your destiny is to improve, if you want your destiny to improve, you have to look at where you're investing and how you're investing. So either you're growing, either you're a shower or a grower, let's put it that way. And if you're a grower, that goes with you. Whatever you grew in, it goes with you. If you're a shower, when you die and afterward, you'll have nothing to show for it. That's the problem with being a shower. You're concerned with how things look. You're concerned with the world. You're concerned with what the society wants you to be concerned with instead of the intelligence God gave you so that you can discern what makes a wiser investment. If you're listening to me, you already know this, but it has to be clarified again and again, and we all have to be reminded again and again until that's simply how you're automatically apportioning your time and attention, until it's established that you are investing wisely, not foolishly. And you've always got the influence of the worldly around you, and the majority investing foolishly. So even when you're investing wisely, in the back of your mind, you might be wondering, am I being foolish? Because I seem to be doing differently than most people. How could it be that all those millions, that the majority is wrong and I'm right? And you have to know that you're right. You have to know that the minority is often correct, and the majority is often wildly off the mark. So invest in yourself, not in the world. Invest in God, your God account, not your bank account. There's nothing wrong with having a nice bank account, but it doesn't go with you. Your God account goes with you.